Hello and welcome to Disha's official YouTube channel. This is Ruchi presenting daily news analysis. Cabinet approves revamped distribution sector scheme. Revamped distribution sector scheme envisages to improve operational efficiencies and financial sustainability by providing result-linked financial assistance to DISCOMs or power departments for strengthening of supply infrastructure. Assistance will be based on meeting pre-qualifying criteria as well as upon achievement of basic minimum benchmarks. Scheme would be available till 2025 to 2026. Power Finance Corporation, that is PFC, and Rural Electrification Corporation, that is REC, will be the nodal agencies. Objectives of the scheme are reduction of aggregate technical and commercial losses to pan-India levels of 12-15% by 2024 to 2025. Reduction of ACS and ARR gap to zero by 2024 to 2025. Developing institutional capabilities for modern DISCOMs. Improvement in the quality, reliability and affordability of power supply to consumers. Components of the scheme are consumer meters and system meters. Prepaid smart meters for all consumers except agricultural consumers. Prioritizing the urban areas, union territories, Amrit cities, etc. Feeder segregation. Funding feeder segregation of agricultural connections to enable solarization under KUSUM. Modernization of distribution system in urban areas. Rural and urban areas system strengthening. Key features: major focus on improving electricity supply for the farmers and for providing daytime electricity to them through solarization of agricultural feeders. Consumer empowerment by the way of prepaid smart metering to be implemented in the public-private partnership mode. Artificial intelligence would be leveraged to analyze data generated from the IT devices to prepare system-generated energy accounting reports every month. All the existing power sector reform schemes such as Integrated Power Development Scheme, Deen Dayal Upadhyay Gram Jyoti Yojana and the Pradhan Mantri Sahaj Bijli Har Ghar Yojana would be merged into this umbrella program. BharatNet Project. Cabinet approved revised implementation strategy of BharatNet through public-private partnership model in 16 states. Under the revised strategy, BharatNet will now extend up to all inhabited villages beyond Gram Panchayats. An estimated 3.61 lakh villages including the Gram Panchayats will be covered. Revised strategy also includes creation, upgradation, operation, maintenance and utilization of BharatNet by the concessionaire, that is private sector partner, who will be selected by a competitive international bidding process. Triple P model with leverage private sector efficiency for operation, maintenance, utilization and revenue generation and is expected to result in faster rollout of BharatNet. The objective is to facilitate the delivery of e-governance, e-health, e-education, e-banking, internet and other services to the rural area. About BharatNet. It is a project of national importance to establish affordable broadband connectivity of 2 Mbps to 20 Mbps for all households and on-demand capacity to all institutions in partnership with states and private sector. It is funded by the Universal Service Obligation Fund generated through universal access levy charged on telecom operators. Its implementation has been taken place in three phases. Phase 1 covered 1 lakh gram panchayats for providing broadband connections. Phase 2 aims to provide connectivity to all the gram panchayats in the country using an optimal mix of underground fiber, fiber over power lines, radio and satellite media. Phase 3 is focused on upgrading the existing infrastructure. Glacial Lake Atlas of Ganga River Basin. The Secretary, Department of Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Regeneration, About the present glacial lake atlas is based on the inventory glacial lakes in part of Ganga River basin from its origin to foothills of Himalayas covering a catchment area of 247,109 square kilometers. The study portion of Ganga River basin covers part of India and the transboundary region. The atlas is available on Bhuvan portal of NRSC, ISRO, India WRIS portal and National Hydrology Project, that is NHP, website of Department of Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Regeneration. The expected utility of atlas is: the atlas provides a comprehensive and systematic glacial lake database for Ganga River basin with a size greater than 0.25 hectares. In the context of climate change impact analysis, the atlas can be used as a reference data for carrying out change analysis, both with respect to historical and future time periods. The atlas also provides authentic database for regular or periodic monitoring changes in the spatial extent and formation of new lakes. The atlas can also be used in conjunction with glacier information for their retreat and climate impact studies. National Hydrology Project. It was started in 2016 as a central sector scheme by the Ministry of Jal Shakti and is supported by the World Bank. It aims to improve the extent, reliability, and accessibility of water resources information. It tries to strengthen the capacity of targeted water resource management institutions and facilitate the acquisition of reliable information efficiently. Union Cabinet approves Memorandum of Understanding between India and Gambia on governance reforms. The Union Cabinet, chaired by the Prime Minister Modi, gave its approval to the signing of the Memorandum of Understanding, that is MOU, between Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances, Government of India and the Public Service Commission, the Republic of Gambia, on refurbishing the personal administration and governance reforms. The signed MOU will provide a legal framework to the cooperation between two countries in refurbishing personal administration and governance reforms in order to improve the existing system of governance by sharing, learning and exchanging the administrative experiences in the area of personal administration and governance reforms. The main objective of the agreement is to strengthen and promote bilateral cooperation between the two nations in the personal administration and governance reforms. It will facilitate the dialogue between the agencies of both the countries. Gambia has also been keen to engage with India to promote cooperation in the areas such as implementation of contributory pension scheme, improving performance management system in government, and e-recruitment in the government. The agreement will help in understanding the personal administration of both the countries and enable in improving the governance systems through adapting, replicating, and innovating some of the best practices and processes. Thank you.